The purpose of e-money is replacing the cash in transactions of small values, thus avoiding its shortcomings, for example French experience with Monio. Monio is designed to reduce the cost of keeping cash and purchasing power to be temporarily transferred in a more efficient manner. This structure should be applied to various retail transactions of lesser value in order to eventually become a substitute for cash. Monio offers great advantages for consumers and retailers. Benefits for consumers are greater transaction speed and potential benefit in the form of a discount on future purchases. Consumers do not have to have an exact amount of cash each time. There will be many mistakes in cash recovery. The owners of the Monio card should carry fewer bank cards, especially if the features of debit and credit cards are included, and thus they would feel more secure. Traders would receive cash before sending material goods or services, loyalty to customers would increase, the process of payment at the place of purchase would be speeded up, thereby reducing the processing costs of the transaction itself. If the benefit of using Monio cards would be greater than the cost, retailers could pay to customers to use such a card. If we make comparison between Monio and POS, it turns out that the former has significant advantages over the POS. Namely, debit and credit cards are not as effective a payment method for low-value transactions as transaction-related costs become higher for retailers and buyers, and e-money can be used with much lower costs. Paying for e-money is followed by much lower costs compared to other payment methods, primarily credit and debit cards. Another argument that accompanies the Monio card is that it has a newer encryption technology compared to other cards, which increases security and limits the possibility of fraud. Because Monio does not require any authorization or identification of the buyer, it allows additional reduction in transaction costs. The new technology of digital payments and currencies will allow real property to be used as a means of exchange. How much e-money will be used depends largely on the motivation of its publishers, consumers and traders. Consumers' demand will depend on the advantages and disadvantages of e-money in the form of payment, issuers' fees, consumer confidence in the use of e-money, ease of use, merchants' readiness to accept e-money. Motivation for the issuers covers the revenues from the collected fee from card users, traders and consumers, income from investing the remaining amount of money, i.e. for banks, issuers, savings of less retained cash, in the range in which e-money replaces cash. Potential shortcomings for publishers can be expected costs for future regulation. The willingness of retailers to accept e-money is closely related to the fee that will be charged by publishers or operators. For consumers and retailers, the most important will be their willingness to embrace new technology. Most researchers believe that the use of e-money will be moderate in the short and medium term, while in the long run e-money can be very widespread.